Namaste. One good morning to y'all. Here is Amisha and Kalpana Parajuli standing in front of you to give a presentation and illustration on the topic evolution. We have seen different organisms around us, how they evolved, how they originated. About the origin of life, there are several hypotheses. In our book, there are given three hypotheses, and they are going to be described by my dearest friend Amisha.
Yes, if you look around us, you can find different kinds of organisms, plants, animals. And when one study about that plants and animals, the question arises in his mind that how did they evolve, when did they evolve, and how the origin of life started. And it is very difficult to give only one answer about origin of life. So there are different theory which is given. In our book there are three theories, and there are theory of spatial creation, theory of spontaneous generation, theory of modern concept of origin of life. First of all, theory of spatial creation. Theory of spatial creation says that the life was originated by the God, of supernatural power, and it has not any scientific reason, so it is not very much accepted, but we can find it in our holy books such as Gita, Bible. And when we talk about theory of spontaneous generation, it is said that all the living things were originated from the non-living substances. It is also said that the Nile River of Egypt can produce different kinds of reptiles such as snake, toad, crocodile, frog, etc. And Von Hammer has also told that the humans are to wait in which plant can produce a mice in 21 hours. But it was rejected by different scientists like Louis Pasteur. And when we talk about theory of modern concept of origin of life, it is said that different macroelements such as carbon, oxygen, hydrogen were united together to form macroelements such as carbohydrate, fats, protein, and they all united together to form a living cell, which is known as process of abiogenesis. Abiogenesis is the process from which an individual gets evolved, and it is being complex more than modern present. Now I'd like to ask some question. Krishna, please stand up. What is mean by abiogenesis? What is meant by abiogenesis?
The interaction to produce the first living cell is called abiogenesis.
Thank you, Sita. You should stand up. What are the theory of evolution?
Theory of creation. Theory of generation. More concept of organism.
Thank you. Now my friend Kalpana will describe about organic evolution. Does anybody know about organic evolution here?
No.
Okay, Nisha, please stand up and say. Organic evolution is defined as the gradual and orderly change in organisms from material. Yes, organic evolution is defined as the gradual change from which organism form one to another, and it is also believed that the complex organism present today are evolved from the past animals, and there are five evidences from which we can describe the organic evolution. There are five evidences. First one is evidence from fossils. biological evidence. Organisms grow and die, and they are buried by any method. They are buried from many years when they are traced on the sedimentary rocks. Some parts of traces are known to be fossils, and it is also known as paleontology. And this evidence from fossils or paleontological evidence can be identified different methods, and they are carbon dating and uranium dating. And there are 5 points that can describe the evidence from fossils or paleontological evidence, and they are first is the organism presented here. The organisms which are adopted here are extinct in the past, and they are for example archaeopteryx. Archaeopteryx have linked between the birds and reptiles. So some organisms which were existed in the past also have link between one form to another form. And evidence from fossils or paleontological evidence can be also described by the geographical structure from place to place. The animals found in different geographical places are different from one to another. Now it's time to describe evidence from comparative morphology. Antelogy refers to the internal structures of study of animals. And this antelogy and morphology can be described through two terms, and they are homologous organs and analogous organs. There are some homologous organs. These are the forelimbs of whale and horse. Man, bat and bird are some of the example of homologous organs. Homologous organs are those organs which are
the time now is
which are similar 7, in structure
20.
But they function differently. Now it's time to discuss about the analogous organs. When the wings of birds and bat are compared with the wings of insects, then that is called analogous organs. Analogous organs and homologous organs together describe us that the evidence from the comparative morphology. For example, some of the example of homologous and analogous organs some of them are evolved from the birds or bats, some of them are evolved from the insects. Now it's time to read about the vestigial organs. Those organs which are functionless and present as reduced structure in our body are known as vestigial organs. Some of the example of vestigial organs of our body can be muscles to move ear and canine lead, nectarine membrane and vermiform appendix. These organs are reduced in our body, but in other organisms it is also present and they are useful. Now it's time to read about evidence from embryological evidence. Does anybody know what is embryo? If not, then I will describe. Describe the different fertilized or different organisms. This diagram also describe the evolution of organism through the embryological stage. The embryo of fish, bird, cow, man are similar when they are originated. Because all fertilized eggs are originated from the unicellular organisms. While studying about the concept of origin of life, a biologist Hegel also describes that entenogy and phylogeny describes this embryological evidence. Now it's time to read about evidence from geographical distribution of organisms. Geographical distribution of organisms. Darwin, a biologist, analyzed that distribution of organisms differ from place to place. Some geographical distribution also states that, for example, ponds, rivers, lakes, they isolated the animals and the animals living in new habitat, they have also evolved a new kind of characters in them, and which describes the evolution, the organic evolution. And geographical distribution of organism can be seen in oceans, seas, rivers and lakes. Now, last but not the least, evidence from connecting animals. Amisha, you stand up. Just stand up. What are homologous and analogous organs? Thank you.
Baba's Island. Question about the archaeopteryx. Archaeopteryx is an animal which have link between the birds and reptiles. So the evidence from connecting animals means the animals those who have two characters evolved from the different species of the animals are said to be connecting animals. And they, some of the example of connecting animals are platypus, archaeopteryx, and protoceratops, etc. Now there are in our book. Now there are given two theories. They are Lamarck's theory and Darwin's theory. The Lamarck's theory is going to be described by my dearest friend. According to what the Kalpana says, theory of evolution. In our book, there are just two, and some of the main contributors of theory of evolution are Jean-Baptiste de Lamarck of France, Alfred Michel Wallace and Charles Darwin of England, and von Helmholtz of Holland are the main contributors in this theory of evolution. And now, first of all, we'll discuss about Lamarckism. And Lamarckism was a theory given by Jean-Baptiste de Lamarck in 1809 and his book Philosophy Geology. He has described the theory of evolution into three main parts, and they are direct environmental effect, use and disuse of organs, inheritance of aquatic factors. Direct environmental effect. According to Lamarck, the environment directly influenced the modification of organs in organism. He believed that the direct environmental effect can change an organism from one to another. And for example, we can take the egg of Himalaya region. They consist of big fur due to the direct environmental effect. Use and disuse of organism. Use and disuse of organism was one of the most. For example, that he has told that with the giraffe were very much small, at past days they were as similar to goat. They used to feed on grass, but likewise they evolved and. Stretch their neck for feeding on the leaf of trees. Now, there are some of the criticism of Lamarckism, and Lamarck has not proved experimentally that use and disuse of organism can form new organ. And according to our need and wish, we can develop organ in our body. And all the acquired characters are not inherent to the new generation. Now my friend Kalpana will describe about Darwin. Thank you, Amisha. Now it's time to discuss about the Darwinism. Theory of Darwinism. Charles Darwin, an English naturalist, published a book about the origin of life in 1859 AD. Before this, Albert Hallis also gives his idea on the topic origin of life in 1858 AD. So there are five points from that Darwinism can be described. The first one is the first one is natural selection.
natural selection, and the second one is struggle for existence, and third one is enormous fertility. Fourth one is origin of species. Nature has its own characteristics, so the organisms which can adapt according to the nature's characteristics, they can survive themselves in the nature. And the natural struggle for existence. Different organisms are on the earth. They grow and die. They have to compete for their survival with another animals. If they can compete, then they are said to be struggle for existence. Enormous fertility. Every organism tends to multiply its offspring by not doubling the population, and that is known as enormous fertility. Origin of species. The different origin, if the organisms can adapt themselves in the nature, and they can origin by the process of evolution, it is known as origin of species. Variation and heredity means the offspring which have their parental characters. Some of them can be different, and they can be fit in the nature, and some of them can also have very different characteristics, and they can be evolved as the very different variation. And this is known as variation and heredity. Last but not the least, now it's time to read about the mutation that is going to be described by my dearest friend Amisha. Mutation was the theory given by the Dutch biologist Hugo de Vries in 1901 AD. And mutation is the process of sudden chromosomal change in an organism. And it is mainly affected by chemical and chromosomal change, which is known as mutants, and the first organism affected by this is known as mutagen. Some of the example of mutation are six finger hand, black patch on the body, cord leaf from the bark, etc. So for today is much. We hope you like our presentation. Anybody have any question to ask? All of you have understood or not? Thank you.
Okay, so today's presentators, Amisha Matt Chetri and Kalpana Basnet. Kalpana Basnet Parajuli, actually. I say Basnet, but she is Parajuli, right? So their presentation was fabulous. So next time, the students who has got the duty must do much better than this. Generally, we compare the presentation of class 10 and class 9. So class 9 presentation is much better than that of class 10. So that class 9 students are paying more attention for their activities, right? So I hope next year, when you go in class 10, you make it more interesting, so that other students who watch our channel will be benefited more, right? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.